ओके
सो फॉर ड्रॉप डाउन लाइक व्हाट इज द एचटीएमएल टैग फॉर ड्रॉप डाउन वी हैव लर्नड एचटीएमएल टैग फॉर ड्रॉप डाउन इज व्हाट सिलेक्ट या एचटीएमएल टैग फॉर ड्रॉप डाउन इज सिलेक्ट सो आई दिस एचटीएमएल पेज आई हैव डिजाइन बाय माई सेल्फ ओके सो बिकॉज आई वॉन्ट टू शो बोथ हाउ टू हैंडल सिंगल ड्रॉप डाउन एंड मल्टीपल ड्रॉप डाउन दैट्स वाई आई हैव मेड इट बाय माई सेल्फ बिकॉज इट्स लाइक बिट डिफिकल्ट टू फाइंड अ सिंगल वेब पेज वेयर देर इज बोथ मल्टीपल एंड सिंगल ड्रॉप डाउन ओके सो वाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन सिंगल एंड मल्टीपल ड्रॉप डाउन इन सिंगल ड्रॉप डाउन वी कैन सिलेक्ट ओनली वन वैल्यू लाइक दिस वन दिस इज अ सिंगल ड्रॉप डाउन वी कैन सिलेक्ट ओनली वन वैल्यू एट अ टाइम बट वाट इज मल्टीपल ड्रॉप डाउन मल्टीपल ड्रॉप डाउन इज दैट ड्रॉप डाउन इन विच आई कैन सिलेक्ट मल्टीपल वैल्यूज लाइक दिस सो दिस इज अ मल्टीपल ड्रॉप डाउन गॉट माई पॉइंट
यस सर
Now, if you see its HTML definition, you will find a difference how HTML differentiate it by its definition. So, if I go to this particular single dropdown, you will see it has the values in the option which is populated in the dropdown and has a select tag. But if we go to the multiple dropdown, you will find it has select multiple is called true. So, when you have an attribute multiple which has value true. In select tag, then it is a multiple drop down. Okay, this is the difference as per HTML definition for multiple drop down and single drop down. So, in single drop down, we can select only single value, and in multiple drop down, we can select multiple values for the same drop down. So, this is my own designed HTML page, so it is stored in local. So, what I have to do is in the similar way, I have opened Google, I just copy the whole link from copy out the whole link from here and just put it in navigate to the whole link so my particular HTML page of the saved in local will be opened in Chrome browser and I can handle it out okay so my first point here is to handle the let's start with the single drop down how to handle it out okay let's make some changes out there which will be needed while just a minute open with notepad okay so here I make out some changes okay I added to some value here just say for example here value is equal to a value. I add out value attribute here because we'll be using it in our co scripting. So we'll have an idea how to use it out. Okay, so I have a value attribute here which has its value. Okay, now let's handle the single drop down first. So, for that, what I have to do is I have to create a object of select class. Getting my point? Let's see. So let me create an object of select class. Select by dot main. Okay, so here I found the XPath for this single dropdown where name is equal to ABC. So it will recognize this particular dropdown because here I have the attribute name as value ABC. So I identified it using by.name is equal to by.name and I pass the attribute value as ABC. Okay, now, now I want to select the value of this dropdown. Okay, so I can do it by three ways. Okay, I can do it by index, that is index will start from 0, 1, 2. Okay, so I can do it by index. Let's say we are doing it by index. So for selecting by index, we use a method select by index. Okay.
Okay.
And pass the index there. Let's see what happens. By default, it is getting it is selected, so it's not selecting it. So if I do it one, let's see, you'll find the change. By default, what is selected? Delhi is selected because it is in the top. If I make it one, so what happened? You'll see the difference. See, Mumbai got selected instead of Delhi. In the previous, set, what is happening? As Delhi is in the top, it is selected by default. So if you also I give the index 0, it gets selected as Delhi because it is present already. But once I gave 1, so it's selected Mumbai. So index start from 0 and 1, 2 and so on. So once I give select by index 1, it got me selected Mumbai as its value.
Okay.
Got my point? Similarly, I can select it. One way to select, there are three ways. The first way is select by index. The second way is select by value. Okay, so what does this particular method does? Select by value, so it will select a particular option by its by the value of its value attribute. Let's say for example, if I want to select Goa, I have to pass C as its argument because values attribute value is C. So once I pass C, you'll see Goa will be selected. Just check it out. Mumbai is getting selected. Why? I have selected deselect. Select by value. Sorry. So here, what is happening? See, Goa is selected. Why? because we passed the value C. And it refers to what? Goa has value attribute whose value is C. So once I passed C in the argument for select by value, it selects Goa. Got my point?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is one way. This is one way. And there is the third way to select. The third way to select is select by visible. Select by visible text. So what is the visible text? The one which we are seeing here in the web page. So let's say for Mumbai, the visible text is what? Mumbai. For Goa, it's Goa. For Delhi, yes, it's sir. Delhi. Let's say after selecting Goa, I will select Mumbai again. So I want to select Mumbai by visible text. So what I'll do? I'll pass on the attribute directly to as an argument to that particular method. So it will select me Mumbai. Got my point?
Yes, sir.
So let's check it out. So at last, I'll be having Mumbai selected. Okay. See, the final selection is Mumbai because at last I selected by value Mumbai. Got my point?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now let's see what I want to do is I selected what this value, but as it is a single drop down, once I do a selection by another way, it get overrides because only one value can be selected at a time. But if I want to select three values here, I can select it easily because it is a multiple drop down. Got my point? So for that, what I have to do is, let's say I have to take another object out there. And here I write the XPath, or not the XPath, it is not the XPath, it is the locator. XPath comes under locator, okay. So I write out the locator for this multiple dropdown. So multiple dropdown has name is equal to XYZ. I can just use it out in the code by name is equal to XYZ. So now I will select here three values similar to this single dropdown in three different ways, but they all will be selected for me in multiple dropdown. Unlike the single dropdown, we selected one value at a time. Got my point? So let's say, for example, I started out it with index. Select by index. Select by index, let's say, for example, I pass it out 2. So which one will be selected? 0, 1, 2, Goa will be selected out. Got my point?
Yes, sir.
So then I pass it out, select by value. Select. So for this one, let's say I pass it out Mumbai. So I'll be passing E. Sorry, I'm selecting deselect. Select. Then what remained is select by visible text. So let's say, for example, I want to select Chennai. Now see, what here happens is I selected in three different ways, okay? And all values will be selected because it is a multiple drop down. Got my point?
Yes, sir.
Okay, let's see what happens once I run it out. See, my all three value was selected in the all the three different ways.
Okay, sir.
Got my point?
Yes, sir.
So there are three ways in which I can select the value of a drop down.
Okay.
Now, I can get out the options of the drop down, either it's a single drop down or multiple drop down. Let's say, for example, I want to get the web element options of single drop down. What here it does, it gave me a list of web element, and this list of web element contains what? These web elements means all the options present in that particular drop down. So now in my list I have this web element, and these web element stored in it. Okay, so get option returns me back the list of option web element present in a select drop down. So let's say, for example, I do want to do an operation in that particular web element. Let's say, for example, for this particular web element I want to derive the visible text. I can derive it out.
Okay,
so let's say, for example, we'll be using for each loop for that. So here, to derive it out, let's say, for example, web element. So what here I'll be doing is I'll be retrieving each web element in the list and printing out it visible text in the console. I have a list of web element on me. I can do any operation I want to do, but for here I can think of only doing a operation to retrieve it visible text in my console. So I retrieved it using .getText. GetText will retrieve me out the visible text present in that particular web element. And what is visible text? Visible text is that text which is visible to me in my web page. Like, say, for example, here is Delhi, Mumbai, Goa. These are visible. So these all are visible text. And here, these visible text are defined out here. Okay. Similarly, anything that is visible to me in the web page, that is a visible text. So this particular, we have a list of web element which contain this web element and this web element, because I have done get operation in the this drop down. So I have these three web element, and for these three web element I want to derive the visible text. So for this web element my visual text will be Delhi, for this Mumbai, and for this it will be Goa, and this all I'll be printing it out in console. So I have used SISO, that is system.out.println. Got my point? So let's check it out. See, Delhi, Mumbai, Goa.
Yes, sir.
Got my point? How is working? Now say, for example, if I have done it for this multiple drop down, it would have been Delhi, Mumbai, Goa, Chennai, because it has four web element inside it, which is option tag. So if you want, you can also check it out. That's not an issue. Just thing I have to do is this one, and let's check it out. I'll be having one more option in it. That's Chennai.
Sir, another one is there. WB select list. That one which selected?
Sorry.
No, sir, it got it. It's fine. It's fine. Sorry, my bad.
See, Delhi, Mumbai, Goa, Chennai. I did get option in my second drop down. That is the multiple drop down. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So this is one point. Now comes the point that is deselect by value. Like I have select by value, select by visible text, select by index. Similarly, I have deselect by value, deselect by index, and deselect by visible text, and also deselect all. And okay, get all selected option, get first selected option. These okay. All method which I told now is exclusive to multiple drop down. This works only in multiple drop down. This doesn't work in single drop down. Okay. And only one method is present. These are generic to the get option, select by index, select by value, and select by visual text. Works out for both multiple and single drop down. And there is also one method is multiple that also works out generic to both. But after that, which method we'll be learning is only exclusive to multiple drop down. So let's end with the inclusive one which works for both, that is multiple. Like say for example, I want to check that particular drop down is multiple or not. Like say for example, this second drop down for me is a multiple drop down, so I can check it out in console with a boolean return value as true or false, it's a single drop down or multiple drop down. So let's say for example, if I do select one dot is multiple, so what this particular line of code will print out in console? True, because this is a multiple drop down for me.
Yes sir.
Yeah. So mute. Hello.
Yes sir.
So what it will be doing is it will be returning me to true because this particular drop down is multiple drop down for me. So let's see it's returning out true for me or not once I run the code. See, it returned me true because that one is a particular drop down is a multiple drop down for me. So it's returned out true. Now, what I have to do is get all the selected options. Like say, for example, here I have three selected values in my multiple dropdown. I want to get all the selected options. See, get all selected options. So what this particular method will do is it will return me those web element which are selected. So it will return me web element of Mumbai, web element of Goa, and web element of Chennai because these three are selected. Okay, so see, if I print the visible text for this list which is populated, it will print me Mumbai, Goa, Chennai instead of Delhi, Mumbai, Goa, Chennai because Delhi is not selected out here. Okay, and this particular function is exclusive. It's only for multiple drop down. It doesn't work for single drop down because in single drop down you can select only one value. So there is no point of getting all selected options. Now, let's say if I print out the visible text of all the selected options, so it will print me only those which are selected. So what I expect here in console, I expect here out as Mumbai, Goa, Chennai, because this particular values are selected.
Okay,
Let's
sir.
see if I run it out, you will find the difference. See, only Mumbai, Goa, Chennai, because those three were selected. Delhi didn't come into picture. Now say for example, what here I got is all those which were selected. Let's say for example, I want only the first selected value. So for me, the first selected value here is Mumbai. Get first selected option dot get text. So it will return me only one web element, because get first selected value option will be only one particular web element, that is Mumbai. So no need to store it in a list, because it will be only one web element. So there's no point of storing it in a list. Rather, I directly use get text on that, because it is a single web element which is returned to me. So for me here, what will be printing? Mumbai. So after Chennai, we'll be seeing at last Mumbai will be printed once I run this piece of code, because for me the first selected value is Mumbai in the multiple drop down.
Okay, sir.
See, Mumbai got printed.
Yes, sir.
Got my point? Now, there is a these from here, like get all selected options, these are only specific to multiple dropdown. It doesn't work with single dropdown. Now, I'll work with deselect by index, deselect by value, and deselect by visible text. These all are also only for multiple dropdown, not for single dropdown. Okay. Now, see, I have to deselect, let's say for example, Mumbai, Goa, and Chennai. See, one point you have to remember, if I have selected Mumbai by visible text, that doesn't mean I will deselect by visible text only. If I have selected Mumbai by visible text, I can deselect by index also. There's no mandatory rule that by which process you have selected the value, we have to deselect by that way. We can see, if I have selected by visible text, I can select deselect it by index. If I have selected by index, I can deselect it by value. So there's any way you can deselect it. Say for example, the first selection I did here is select by index 2. So what it will be selecting for me? What is selected? Goa. So now I will deselect that by value. I have selected it by index, but I will deselect it by value. Okay. See, deselect by value. That is F. Yeah. Let's put a thread so that you will be able to see one by one, because it's too fast. Now my Goa got deselected. I selected by index and deselected it by value. So now for me, I have to deselect Mumbai. Let's deselect it by index, right? Deselect by index 1. Now, I deselected Goa and Mumbai. The left one is Chennai. So I have to deselect it, right? Deselect it by visible text, that is Chennai. Okay, so here I am deselecting all one by one. So let's see what happens once I run this piece of code. Got to see what happened, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so here I deselected one by one. Let's say, for example, I want to deselect all the values at a one go. Okay, I want to deselect all the value at one go rather deselecting it one by one. So what I have to do is I can just comment it out by deselecting it one by one. Just do what is dot deselect all. See what it will happen is deselected all at one time. What my point?
Yes, sir.
So you got the difference, right? So there what was happening is it was deselecting one by one, and here I deselected it at one go by deselect all. See, there I deselected it in one go, here it got deselected one by one. One at a time. See, Goa got selected, deselected, Mumbai got deselected, and Chennai got deselected. One at a time. Depending on the method I have used. So you got a clear idea how to deal with a select class, deselecting, selecting, dealing with the options of it.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Right.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So here we used a loop that is for each loop. So what is this? Let's try to understand out here. In the list of web element, I stored all the option web element in the LST one. So here, instead of normal traditional for loop, I used for each loop. Okay, so what is for each loop? So what it's explained is for each web element WB in list LS1, iterate my loop. So let's say, for example, in LST1, there are four values. So for first iteration, WB will be, but web element WB is a single web element, but list has a multiple web elements stored in it. So here what it will be doing is for first iteration in WB, the first value, web element value present in the list will be stored it out in WB. So here this is actually a for each loop. So it starts here and ends here. Because it has a single line, my curly braces is optional. I can use it or cannot use it. But it's, if multiple lines are there, we can mandatorily have to use curly braces. But as it was a single line, I didn't use it. But this particular line of code comes inside this for each loop. So what is the advantage of for each loop instead of traditional for loop is, in traditional for loop, I have to mention the iteration, the number of times it will iterate. Like for example, I have to iterate it for 10, so I have to give a count 10, I have to do all that. For each loop, it iterate by itself for the number of element present in the list. If my list has three values, it will iterate three times by itself. I don't have to mention it like you iterate out for three times. So here what it will be happening is for each web element WB in list LS1 do this particular operation. So for first iteration, it will store the first value of LST1 in WB. So once it's stored in WB, I just did an operation like get text on it. So I printed it out its value in here. So similarly, it has three web element or four web element. It will iterate out four times by itself. So but the second iteration, it will be having WB gets stored with the second value of that LST1. So once it gets stored with the second value, so once I dot get test, so my second web element text get printed out in console. So got my point?
Yes sir, got it.
So now we'll be dealing with getting the XY coordinate of a particular web element. Okay. Let's say for example, once I open this particular site, this particular web element has a particular XY coordinate for me. So let's say for example, while testing a application which has map or some, you can say placing of object, you can go use this XY element or get the XY element coordinates of that web element and use it out. Or you can say you are swiping a page. You want to swipe out from a particular coordinate in the screen to a particular coordinate in the screen, there you need this location method to find out the coordinates of wave element. Like say for example, I have to go from wave element 1 to wave element 2, so I can do it out by location, finding out the XY location coordinate of that. So how to find out the XY location coordinate? Let's check it out. Let's say for example, for this particular single drop down, I want the XY coordinate. Okay, let's say for example, see, so here we are using a point data type. So what this point data type does, it stores the XY coordinate of a particular web element. So this point data type will be storing my XY coordinate of this particular drop down. Like say for example, I print it out here. It will print me the XY coordinate of that. See, it printed out 385.61. So what I got is the XY coordinate of that particular web element in XY format. Let's say for example, I only want X and I only want Y. So what I'll do is, so here I got both the XY coordinate, but here I will just get out X and Y. See, only x and y got printed out here. Okay, so what you will be doing now as assignment is just go to Mercury demo. Log in with the credentials, that is Mercury and Mercury. Now you change its value to one way, you change its default value from 1 to 3, you change its default value from this to London, you can change the default value from March to June. Every drop down default value will be changed to another value. Now also change every default value will be changed, either it's drop down or checkbox. Here from no preference to any preference, then continue. Similarly change these checkbox values, then continue. Then here you populate the values. Here also you change this to some values rather than different values. You change every web element which is editable to another value, either it's a text area or checkbox or drop down, and complete end to end flight booking. This will be the task for you for the day.
Okay.
Okay.